of my portable Hire washing machine. This is the HLP23E. Mine came damaged, but I kept it because it worked and I didn't feel like dealing with any bull crap and returning it. It's got handles. Take my word, it's got handles. I don't feel like moving it. It's pretty easy to move. If you're smaller or just prefer, you could always put it on a dolly. I just pick it up and from the handles and rope, you know, carry it out of my closet without any problems. Next to it, I have the Avanti portable dryer. This is very light and very easy to take out, but I'm not going to be talking about that. That's just a tumble dryer that works on a standard outlet, so it does take longer to actually dry your clothes, but it's it beats air drying if you're in a rush and don't want to iron. So anyway, here's the washer. I just want to show how it hooks up. This is the drainage hose. I do this. A little hard with one hand, but I just want to run it through here because this will move. You want to have this secured. And here's the main water intake hose. And it clips on like this. This is the piece that comes with it. You screw this on. It should fit just about any kitchen faucet, maybe bathroom faucet. You push down here and clip it on. And that's it. And you turn your water on. Now, the temperature of the water is controlled by your sink. I like warm, so I put a little bit of hot, a little bit of cold. And that's all you need to concern yourself with. The washer will actually handle the flow control. So you don't need to worry about attending. You just turn the water on and let the washer do its thing like any other washing machine. So it's a standard washer once you put it in place and hook up the tube. Plug it in. Everything you need to know is on the front panel here. Cycle table, standard, heavy, gentle. This is my favorite. Number 4 is the quick wash. That's about 20-21 minutes for everything. The wash cycle, spin, rinse cycle, spin, and the quick spin dry, which does a very respectable job of drying the clothes where you can just hang them out or go from the spin dry to a tumble dryer, whatever else you like to do. Get the lint trap here. Pops out easily. And then places for your liquid detergent. Dispenser for the powder detergent, I guess. I don't know. I don't use that. I just drop my detergent in. And you could use anything like you'd use in a regular washer. I use Tide Pods. I could just dump the clothes in, drop the pod in, and let it do its thing. One question that's certainly going to get asked is, does it fit a queen-size sheet? Yes, it does, easily. I've never had a problem with capacity. Despite it being portable, it doesn't have the agitator in the middle that takes up more space, so you fit a bigger load than you'd think. And your clothes also don't get hooked on the agitator when you try to remove them. So I'm going to put a queen-size sheet in now. I don't let the water go first. I just dump my clothes in or whatever else. I'll put a second, the fitted sheet, also queen-size because, you know, it's coming from the same bed. And a couple pillowcases. And for good measure, I'll just see washcloth, another washcloth, underpants, and some socks. It's a pretty big load, actually. Not a problem at all. I can do several pairs of jeans, shirts, underwear, socks in one load. I've never had a problem with the capacity. I do live alone, but I've had a roommate for the past month. And you know, if we each do one load of laundry a week, it's not a problem. So I'm going to turn it on. Normally I pick number 4, which is the quick wash, and then set the water to high. I love these things. You just drop it in. You don't even have to worry about the water being in first. Not that I do, but you can't eat these. You probably can eat these. You shouldn't eat them. They look nice, but they're just really convenient. This cellophane-ish stuff on the outside, the water dissolves it and releases everything in a when it's meant to be released. That's it. So we just hook the tube up, secure the drainage, and we set the cycle we want. You know what? I'm going to do quick. Put it on high and press start. Time remaining is 21 minutes, and that BB is, according to the legend, it means wash. So we're filling up with water. This doesn't have the clear top. The smaller model, higher, portable. It's about as low as the dryer. Fits a pretty good load. I got this one by accident, but it's a happy accident because I could fit so much in it. It shuts off with an error if you open the lid, or if you don't have the water on, it'll tell you. Water comes from up here. They normally come down and, you know, I guess wash the powder into there. But that's a pretty big load. 2 queen-size sheets, 2 pillowcases, 4 pairs of socks, 2 washcloths and underwear, and my phone's ringing. So I'm going to let this continue, and I'll be back later. 3 minutes in, and it's agitating. Well, I can't show you how it agitates, because take my word, it agitates. For everything I threw in there, I did not overfill it. I mean, you don't want to go to the top, but you can go well over halfway. My birds ate my shades. I had to tape paper up there because they would perch upon there and eat my shades. And it didn't really help because now they just grab onto the rope here. They cling on the rope, swing, and just eat my shades. There's no point in repainting with these things. Look, they ate some more shades over here. It's hanging off. It's just they're just eating my house. It's on the last drain cycle. Actually, it's on the spin cycle now, spitting the water out. Shakes a little bit. I've never had a problem with it shaking too much, though. I had it on the dolly, but I took it off the dolly because it was really light enough for me, personally, to just pick up by the handles and... Alright, so... I got Nintendo underwear. I'll probably have to edit this out of the video. Let's just... While they're hanging on the door, I'd rather not say. They're just there. This is my closet. I store everything. I'm approaching 40, so I should probably edit this out of the video too. It was my nephew's. So here's where I keep my washer, dryer, and various other things. And it goes back in there when I'm done. It's quite easy. So if you want to keep it there permanently, keep it there permanently. You can buy a splitter to split the water. And it's, despite these loud birds, hopefully you're getting an idea of how loud the machine is. It's not very loud at all. It's never been an annoyance. Well, there's my eating area. I've sometimes eaten lunch while I've done my laundry, which I'll probably do next time, but it never bothered me to have it running right alongside me. It's a very good spin cycle. It really is. It's among the better washers in that regard. See if I can. Yeah, it's quick. I'm gonna go ahead and close it up again and let it continue. If you hit the pause button first, you don't get that annoying beep when you try to check in on your stuff. I really wish they had made this clear, like a smaller model, just because getting to see it would make me happy, because that's what my life's been reduced to. And after this spin cycle is done, it's still getting water out. I just take everything up in a bunch and throw it into my tumble dryer, which I will not be reviewing, at least not now. These are awesome. I recommend these. Throw the clothes in, throw the pot in, let the laundry do its thing while you're gone. 2 minutes left, it's just finishing the spin cycle. If you have an apartment where you just want to do your laundry in some location that's not properly set up for it, like you don't have your high voltage, high wattage output, you want to just plug it to a standard output, standard sink, I can't recommend this highly enough. It's really useful for apartment dwellers especially. Very easy to use, washes as good as the real thing, and certainly beats the hell out of the laundromat. Quick, and the clothes come out dry enough to hang. You don't need to wring any of that stuff. It's just a great alternative to making the trip. There it is.